Lift up your two hands. Our King, we lift up our hands this morning, signifying our helplessness in ourselves. Our hope, all our help is in you, O Father. We worship you. Receive all the glory. Receive all the praise. Lord, we want to hear from heaven. You said in your word that weeping, sorrow, agony may endure for a night, but joy, rejoicing comes in the morning. Lord, and you also gave us a command that rejoice in the Lord always. Lord, release the ingredients of rejoicing upon your children. Let the heavens break forth and let the power of God Most High stream from the throne of God and decorate every life under the sound of my ministration, under the sound of my voice this morning, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Come down in the fullness of your power and show yourself strong in our midst. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lift up your right hand. Say, oh Lord, my Father.
Oh Lord, my Father.
We enthrone Jesus.
We enthrone Jesus.
We enthrone the rule of heaven.
We enthrone the rules of heaven.
Over White House.
Over White House.
We enthrone Jesus.
We enthrone Jesus.
In USA.
In USA.
No power.
No power.
No satanic kingdom.
No satanic.
We take over the White House.
We
bring the hand of heaven
upon the White House.
We restore Jesus in America. In the name of Jesus, Father, we decree
this government
of Donald Trump, we favor black men. We favor the black. It will favor everybody. As he favors the white, so shall it be for the black. So shall it be for everybody. Somebody said, Donald Trump, we speak to you. Your government, we favor the black and favor the white equally. It will favor Nigeria. If you believe in God, say amen.
Amen.
If you know the Lord has heard us, I'm not just praying this prayer because I'm not just praying. There are things that this man has uttered, but me, I believe. I'm a black man. Maybe before his tenor runs up, I will be there. And when I make up my mind to go there, nobody will stop me. When you make up your mind to go there, no demon will stop you. He will favor all of us. At the day he's going to sit down on the throne of the presidency, the God of heaven will possess his mind. If you believe, say another amen.
Amen.
Give a clap of free to Jesus and have your seat. Be seated. The topic of today is a very unique one. It says, rejoice in the Lord. How many times? On Wednesday, divine encounter? Is it on Sunday alone? How many times? When? Is it just 7 days in a week? 365 or 66 in a leap year degree. Always rejoice in the Lord. Always. It's my prayer that the good Lord will give us understanding to this word in the name of Jesus. Tonight, I have preached this message in my dream. And when I woke up, it was like I was lacking words. But you were not in the dream. So I would try and say something. If you had been in the dream, I would just come here and say, remember what we said in the dream, and go and work on it. But you were not there. So I may the Lord help me to bring these things out the way it happened there. I have a question for all of us. Is it possible to rejoice in the Lord always? The Bible confirms the word of God that scriptures can never be broken. Heaven and earth, it is better for heaven and earth to do what? To pass away than for the smallest letter of the word of God to fall to the ground. It is better for heaven to roll away and for the world to sink than for this word of God to fail. Paul wrote this letter. Let's open our Bibles to Philippians chapter 4, verse 4. Philippians 4, 4. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say what? Rejoice. Let's pause first. The Bible says, once has God spoken. How many times have I heard it? Twice have I heard it. That power belongs to God. If God says something once and we hear it twice, what about when God says it twice? He said, rejoice in the Lord always. Again I say what? God is repeating this thing twice because it has enormous importance to us. And in verse 5, let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Look at verse 6 very well. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Verse 7, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ. You are not following me. Through what? Say amen to that scripture. Is it possible to rejoice in the Lord always? Somebody made a comment one day. I read a write-up and the person said, Nigerians will not be shocked to be in hell. Because if you talk about the sun, it's like hell. If you talk about the hardship in Nigeria, people are living free. It's like they are in prison. If you talk about the bad roads we have in Nigeria, he says, so when Nigerians get to hell, it will not look new because they have been living inside something that looks like hell. But when those in the developed countries, when they get to hell, all those Ajebota who have been used to AC and all this cold environment, they will be shocked. I know there is a big lie in what the person said because there's nothing you can compare to hell. Me, I'm in heaven. Praise the Lord. Nigeria is not in hell. God will change us in Jesus' name. Amen. Paul, as at when he wrote this letter, this is one of the best reasons I have to believe the word of God spoken by Paul here. As at when Paul wrote this letter, Paul was in prison. And he was writing to the Philippians church and he was encouraging them. He said, rejoice in the Lord always. I am repeating it again. Again, I say what? Rejoice. How can we rejoice in the Lord, especially now that we have recession? How can we rejoice in the Lord when money is scarce? And when you even struggle to hold the money, to go to the market and buy something with the money is a challenge. When money is scarce, things are supposed to be cheaper. Is that true? But this time around, money is scarce, things are costs. Double wahala. When I went to the market, I said, let me just buy a few oil. 75 centiliter of oil For the first time, they said it's 500 naira. I was confused. And groundnut oil is even cheaper than palm oil. For the first time, we have made history in this Nigeria that even tomatoes will be costlier than apple. And now, it's oil. And then somebody is standing before you and telling you that rejoice in the Lord always. How will you believe this? How can we believe this word of God? When people are dying out of hunger, in fact, some people who came out and said, this is a chosen one, God has spoken to me. They have come back again and they are saying, everybody is dying. I don't call person name. But this kind of time, we are being pushed in Nigeria. How can we rejoice always? Is this word of God true? Is it true? May the Lord help us. I have another question for you personally. Are you rejoicing in the Lord always? If you are rejoicing always, let me see your hand. I want to thank God for those who raise up their hands. But if we go to your bedroom and check your pillow, are we not going to see tears there? No tears. Who is qualified to rejoice in the Lord always? This rejoicing is not the rejoicing that takes place on Friday night and Saturday night in the club. This type of rejoicing is the one you have in the Lord. And because it has something to do with your changing God that has the ability to change situations that refuse to change and situations that are changing against the change that we want. Because it is connected to this God that can change the impossible to become possible. This change is the type that is constant and that will make sure that your rejoicing is constant. We are serving the God that has the ability to take control over time. The God that has the power to take a portion of time out of eternity and split it into days, into years, into months, into seconds, into hours. And still have the power to control every tiny bit of it. Let's look at the reality of the Christian joyous life. The first thing I want us to understand is that joy is not something that any human being can manufacture. We can't produce joy by our own power. Some of the things we call joy, they are not joy. They are happiness. Happiness is short-lived. It's ephemeral. It's temporary. It has to do with a short period of time. But joy is bigger than happiness. You can be happy without having joy. You can be happy without having joy. Sometimes too, you can have joy and not be happy. Happiness is dependent upon the happenings around you, the circumstances around you. But joy has to do with the happening inside of you. Jesus told the disciples, and he told them, in the world you shall have tribulation, but in me you shall have what? You shall have peace. That is why he commanded us to abide in him. If you look at this passage we read, verse 7, Philippians 4, 7, he said, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, will keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Joy is the fruit of the Holy Spirit. So before you talk about rejoicing always, you have to enter an agreement, a contract. You have to covenant yourself with the God that gives the Spirit abundantly without measure. And when you receive the Holy Spirit inside of you, the anointing of the Lord will start bearing this fruit called joy. Galatians chapter 4, verse 22. Joy is the fruit of the Spirit. It's 5:22. Galatians 5:22. The fruit of the Spirit. These are things that the Christian life produces without stress. So it doesn't matter what happens in the world, so long as God has said you are going to rejoice always, you just believe it and you live by that word of God. Forget about what you see around you. Once you do this, God will definitely produce this fruit through his Spirit in you. Say amen.
Amen.
Say another amen.
Amen.
One thing we must do is that we must follow this principle. In verse 6, it says, be careful for nothing. There is somebody that Jesus wants us to imitate. Jesus said, unless you repent and make yourself like one of these little children, you will not enter the kingdom of God. What is Jesus saying? Let me tell you one of the meaning of that word of Jesus. Babies, children, they have no worries in life. Do they worry? Whether you have received salary or not, they don't care. If they see an aeroplane flying, they will tell you, mommy, buy that aeroplane for me. And once you open your mouth and say, don't worry, I will buy it, they will tell the whole world, tell all the children that mommy is going to buy an aeroplane for me. That is how they believe. Whether there is food in the house or not, they don't know. All they know is that, mommy, I am hungry, I need food. There is something I've noticed about infants. They don't squeeze their faces. Anytime you play with them, they will always smile. Is that true? They cry because they can't talk. And when they are feeling stomach ache, they can't tell you, I am feeling it. So they cry. They scream. If not, it's not because they are sorrowful. Every time babies are happy. And this is the kind of life that God wants us to live. Let me tell us, if a Christian dies, any Christian dies because of BP, if you're always thinking about the things of life and it increases your blood pressure and you die, that one is suicidal. You stand the risk of not entering heaven because you kill yourself. If those who live up to their old age are meeting Jesus and telling Jesus, thank you, I fulfill my days on earth. And then someone is meeting Jesus and telling Jesus that, Jesus, the trouble for world too much. I won't try to kill the problem, but the problem kill me. I pray tire. As I was praying, you did not answer me. Why? And then Jesus will open this Bible and refer you to this general hospital for those who have high blood pressure. That, didn't I tell you that be careful for nothing? If you must have this joy, this rejoicing, you must forget about whether you are owing or whether things are bad, whether things are good. You must forget about them and allow the joy of the Lord to be your strength. If you cannot allow God to produce strength in you through his joy, the devil is always around to produce sadness in you that can cause you to be weighed down. The strength we need to live life is not outside of us, it's in us. The Bible says, greater is he. I can't hear somebody in their house. Greater is he than the recession. Than the recession in Nigeria. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. So our strength is from inside. It's not from without. It's from within. For if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead lives inside of you, that same spirit will also revitalize. We also quicken. We also give life to your mortal bodies. That is the scripture. Why is it that we are not rejoicing always? Some of us, we carry the whole troubles in the world and we'll put them in our minds. May the Lord deliver us in Jesus' name. There are these three things that go together. And these things, they are prayers, work, and faith. Prayers, work, and faith. If you are living in this world and you want to rejoice all the time, you want to rejoice always, walk as if you will succeed by walking alone. Some of us are too lazy. A man of God preached one day. We invited a man of God one day in this church some years ago. And he was tempted to make the statement that those who pray and fast all the time, they are always poor. I did not believe it. He went to the extreme. There is nothing bad in fasting and praying all the time. Is it bad? Jesus said, wash and pray. There is nothing bad. What about a situation, someone who fasts every day and does nothing at all in his or her life? In the morning, you are in church. In the evening, you are in church. You have nothing doing apart from that. If you are a retiree or you are old, you are sick, either in your spirit or in your body, you are sick in your mind, you want healing, there is nothing about that. Nothing wrong about that. But people, two hands, two legs, two eyes. Unfortunately, some of those people who sleep in church go to their compounds. You will hear another version of their names. Say, this wicked woman, touch her bucket, you go lose one of your eye. This one, I not go there. He dey church now, if he come back, all the prayers, now your head, you go put and put. Walk as if your success depends on work alone. And after walking, as you walk like that, pray as if your breakthrough depends on what? On prayers alone. And then also, believe the grace of God as if you are among the Israelites in the wilderness who were feeding on manna and quails alone. If you can do these three things, some of us, we work so hard, but we don't get the results of our working. Some of us, we pray so hard and work so hard, but we walk without faith and we pray without faith. So if you can work so hard and pray so hard and throw the whole of your faith upon God, there is nothing that can stop you from getting results. Until the church of God learns how to marry these three things together, we will continue to make mistakes. May the Lord deliver us from this ignorance in the name of Jesus. we must do is that we must do good always. Let me give you one secret. If you are not happy, any day you are not happy, just take some gifts, take some money, take some food items and enter the streets. Look for those who don't have to eat and give to them. Give to one person. Go to another person. Give to another person. Go to the third person. Give to the third person. You will see that before you know it, you are happy again. Is that true? If you want to rejoice all the time, find rejoicing for others. Make people happy. If you want to be happy, if you want to be joyful all the time, also make people joyful. Don't be an instrument of somebody else's fall. Plan good for others. And then also, in all your ways, acknowledge the Lord. Acknowledge God. Everything you do. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 7. Let me read it out for us. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord, and do what? And depart from evil. It shall be head to thy navel, and marrow to thy bones. Praise the Lord. Everything you do, fear the Lord. Acknowledge him. There was a day the disciples were to cross to the other side, and Jesus made them to enter the boat. Jesus made the disciples to do what? To enter the boat themselves. And then he went to pray. A time came, they started facing storm. And that was the day the disciples realized that their master, Jesus Christ, can walk on top of water. When they started facing troubles, they have to call on Jesus. If they had entered the boat with their own mind, without acknowledging God, who would they call upon? For the years I have been in ministry, there is something I'm experiencing. People only run to God when they start having problems in their businesses, in their relationships. Scarcely you see people coming to the man of God to say, man of God, a man is coming to seek for my hand in marriage. What is the Lord saying about it? How many of us do that here? Most times what we get is that, man of God, pray for me, man of God. Men are wicked, men are wicked. All men are the same. Men are wicked. What happened, sister? He said, we have been together for the past 10 years. We're sorry to say, I know it's a sin. We have aborted many children. Today, he just woke up and told me that it's over between us. Who did you consult? Did you consult the man of God before you entered for the past 10 years? Consult God. God, this journey, how is it going to look like? A man was seeking a lady's hand in marriage, and the lady said, I can't marry this man. Why? He said, the jeep, they shake. She agreed that the man has a jeep, but her problem with the jeep is that the jeep is shaking. And that reason disqualifies that man from being the husband. May the Lord deliver us in the name of Jesus. Listen, the land of Israel that the Bible says is flowing with milk and honey. The Israelites, they look at the land, and what they were seeing rock, desert. The place was so dry. And some of them said, why should we inherit this land even? Do you know that the small portion they have, they even want to take it from them? Who? The people, they refused to drive away from the dry places. They never knew that there was crude oil under. Everywhere was dry, but there were natural resources under the dry land. Bishop Arabo, who used to be here, he said he was a church teacher. I wanted to marry a lady. And the lady said, me, marry a church teacher. I can't. Today, the man is a bishop. If he had still been single, many people would be writing application. But you don't know what the man passed through. The wife is enjoying today. Is that not so? When the wife saw the man, did she see Bishop on the face of the man? Expenses. Some of us, our expenses are too much. Your eyes has a budget for eyelash. Your nails, your toes, manicure and pedicure, 15 naira. Your body, your pomade, for Christ, even your hair. Waiting. And when you get a man who cannot meet up with this budget, he said, get out. Is it money? There are some women and men in marriages, they have all the money in the world, but they don't have love. Tell your neighbor, if you want to rejoice tomorrow, marry for love. Don't marry for money. We should be able to have insight and consult God. There are questions I ask. How old is he? What is he doing? What is his qualification? Does he drink? Does he smoke? Does he womanize? Does this man party? Some of us don't ask these questions. In fact, I was very angry one day when one of our brothers came to me and said, I want to get married, but I have a problem. I said, what's the problem? He said, Jesus, the lady said she wants to go and test me first. Yes! Before they can come before the altar and from house or in the vehicle, the lady will be the first one to wear veil. Which veil? There is nothing to cover again. Veil now for virgins. Not before people who don't travel the whole world finish because of only one job. Ashawo job. If you want to have joy tomorrow, go and consult God. It was there. A lady brought woman one day. In fact, the mother was so disappointed. And the lady said, I like this one. So we had to pray. And God said, not this one. Another one came. I like this one. God said, not this one. It was there. Another one. I just shook hands with her. I said, congratulations. Congratulations. They are married now. If something happens tomorrow, that one has the boldness to come before God and say, God, you asked me to enter these boats. Don't consult God when your heart is broken. Consult God when your heart is intact. Where they never shook knife puts. When he never they bleed. That time, now you go meet God. Say, God, what are you saying? Before you enter the business, consult God. What? First, before you enter. Not everything that glitters. And some brothers who fail to consult God, you they like shiny, shiny thing, well. You know, they see one news, you heard the news, that during marriage, a lady ran outside. I don't want to marry again. During reception, may that not be your portion in Jesus' name. That's not even the worst. Do you know that makeup can scatter marriage? Eh? Brothers, don't be deceived. When you are seeing, this makeup can fill some holes you will not understand. And when some brothers, for the first time, we see the woman coming out from the bedroom and see the marks on the faces, some of those tribal marks, pimples, they will pray first. I pray, this is not the wife I married. Some marriages have broken up. I'm not saying you shouldn't make up your face if you want to. But allow the man to see your natural face before you go to the altar. If he wants to go inside, let him go. If he doesn't like, let him do what? Don't deceive people. Don't deceive people. Be natural. Let who likes you come for you. Know that somebody will marry you because of the smoothness of the face. Just overnight. After honeymoon, first night, then they are not seeing another face. Be natural. If you want to have this rejoicing always, let people know who you are. I don't need to tell you everything about myself with my mouth before you know me. If you want to be my friend, you have to package yourself very well first before you come and be my friend. I don't pretend in my life. As you are seeing me here now, this is my life. Then before we round up, there is another aspect of this message I want us to hear. And I want to read the scripture to us. Give, it shall be given unto you, good measures shaken together and running over. Running over.
Give. Running over.
Praise the Lord. Let me read the scripture to you. Luke chapter 3. Give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that ye met without, it shall be measured to you again. We are in worry. Make a break and down. Make everybody hear us. He said, make you give, they go give you back. Oh. And the one where they will give you so, now the one where full remain yakata. Now they go press, compress and wear, package them. They will come use two hands, lift them up. Pour and put for your lap. He said, now the measure. When you take measure, give person, neither will take to wait. During this message, I said, if you want to have joy, seek for the joy of others. This is where we will hear the message today. I cannot forget this thing because in the dream, I was telling some persons this thing this night. It is what you sow that you do what? You reap. I know a lady. She told me a part of the story of her life, and she said, when I was in school, I used to boast that I am going to marry as a virgin. And she will always tell one of her friends. And then the friends started pressurizing her that everybody is doing it. Why don't you do it? It doesn't mean if you marry as a virgin, the man will call you a fool. That you're not wise. And then the same friend made some connections and she started a relationship. The same friend who made the connection went to another person, counted her money, and gave to the guy that, look, call this man. The boyfriend said, call him. Tell him that you are the boyfriend of this lady and that he is taking your girlfriend from you. Do you understand the story? Set up. The one said, have a boyfriend. The lady now has a boyfriend. The same friend went and paid another boy. Called the boyfriend and scattered the relationship. Is that lady a human being? If you want to rejoice always, do not plan evil against anybody. Because what you give is what will be given back to you. And there was problem, and the relationship scattered. I stopped there. Let me not finish the story. But the repercussion is on ground now. The repercussion is what? It's on ground now. You have to live your way very clean. There is a way you live your life. And even if Babalawo takes the leaves of this earth and make any incantation, the leaf will say, no, I have nothing against this person. Even if the person speaks to the sun, just as it happened in the days of Balak and Balaam. Balaam will still come and say, nobody can curse the one the Lord has blessed. Do we have people here who will tie something together and say this marriage cannot work? This marriage, it cannot work so long as this boy did not bring the lady to me because I was not honored. This marriage over my dead body cannot work. Do we have people like that here? Do we have people in this place who are communicants and in the coven they still drink and eat human blood in this place? Do we have them? Do we have cultists in this place? A man confessed one day and he said, after killing a pregnant woman, he opened the stomach of this woman. He opened the belly, tore the womb, and brought the baby and removed the head. You are shouting Jesus. Do we have people who can shout Jesus in church because of stories like this, yet they have aborted that many times? Eh? It is the girl who gave birth to unwanted baby that is a sinner. The one who aborted in the clinic is a saint. May the Lord deliver us in the name of Jesus. I want people to be serious from this moment. I want people to restructure their lives. If you want to experience this joy, I want you to be serious from this moment. Be on your feet. Let us pray. We will take two prayer points. Two. The first one, you will talk to your God that in any way I have succeeded in helping my enemy to kill my joy. Lord, forgive me and wake up my joy. Open your mouth and begin to talk to your Father. In any way I have succeeded in helping my enemy to swallow my joy. Lord Jesus, help me today. Forgive me and restore my rejoicing. Round up your prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Lift up your two hands to heaven. Father, we thank you for your word that we have heard. We lift up this, your children, to you. Lord, forgive every ignorance.
Amen.
Forgive every act of wickedness.
Amen.
Lord, forgive us of our faithlessness.
Amen.
Help us to believe your word.
Amen.
And Lord, I pray for as many that are being oppressed in this place by the devil. In any way the devil is stealing your joy, today may the judgment of heaven disgrace our devil in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the Lord God Almighty restore your peace.
Amen.
May the joy and the peace that passes all understanding come upon your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord that passes all human understanding rule your heart from this moment. Thank you, our Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.